नियतिकृतनियमरहितां ख्लादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. वि हेव् फोर् मोर् दोषास् लेफ्ट् इन् द पदैकदोष पदैकदेशगतं. लेट्स् लुक् इन् टु देट्. ऐ थिङ्क् वि फिनिश्ड् वित् नाट् अवाचकं. वि हेव् टु स्टार्ट् वित् अवाचकं, रैट्? ओके. So avachakam we saw in padagatam, it was that adatari or jantu, where only one word or prabhra bhrata, where in vakyagatam we saw that it is even if grammar, with using the grammar rules, we can form the shabda, we can form the padam, but still it does not give you the desired meaning. So the ultimately why these are all doshas are because vivakshitartha pratyaya virahaha, that is your main point because of which these are called doshas. So for avachakatvam, the shloka that he gives here is, let me take up the text. One minute. चापाचार्यः त्रिपुरविजयी कार्तिकेयः विजेयः शस्त्रव्यस्तः सदनमुदधिः भूरियं हन्तकारः अस्त्येव एतत् किमु कृतवता रेणुका कण्ठबाधां बद्धस्पर्धस्तव परशुना लज्जते चन्द्रहासः. दिस् इस् अ श्लोका फ्रम् बालरामायणम्. दिस् इस् रिटन् बै राजशेखर. हियर् रावण अड्रेस् इस् अ श्लोका टु परशुराम. See, he accepts that Parashurama is also an equal warrior of an equal status here. Both Parashurama and Ravana are of equal, because both of them like Shiva, they have worshipped Shiva and they have attained all the astras from him. So he says here, Chapacharyaha. Ravana accepts Parashurama and he says, Chapacharyaha Tripura Vijayi. Kartikeyaha Vijayaha, that is the next one. So the first one is your Acharyaha for Chapam. Chapa is Dhanur. Dhanur Vidya Guruhu Tripura Vijayi, Tripurasya Vijayi Yaha Maheshwaraha Shivaha Sayeva Tava Guruhu Asti. In Dhanur Vidya, he is your preceptor. The next, being you have a great guru is one thing. What is your achievement? Anybody will ask you that. See, I have studied from this person, I have studied, that is not enough, right? What is your achievement is the next question that someone will say. So that also I accept, Ravana says to Parashurama. He says, Kartikeyaha Vijayaha, Vijayaha Vijitaha, Tvaya Vijitaha. So that is the problem word here. Again, we will go to the dosha later. So Kartikeyaha Vijayaha Vijitaha Tvaya Kartikeyaha Vijitaha. So I accept that also, because there is a Purana Katha where he wins over Skanda and Kartikeyaha Vijayaha. I think there is one in one shlokam, he says where Krauncha Bedaha, just like how Skanda killed that mountain, you know, there Krauncha-sura was took the shape of a mountain and he killed that mountain. Parashurama also wanted to prove that he can be as good as Skanda, and so he also shatters a mountain in a similar manner. So he says he is won over Kartikeya. So Kartikeyaha Vijitaha Shastra Vyastaha Sadanam Udadihi. Udana, what is your house? Parashurama's entire sadhanam, his place of vasasthalam, shastra vyastaha udadihi eva sadhanam. Parashurama, you know, the Kerala part is called Parashurama Kshetram. Even some old people, even now in Tamil Nadu, we say it is called Parashurama Kshetram, because Parashurama used his shastram and he pulled the ocean back to form this land, and he took over that land. So that is where he resided after winning over all the Kshatriyas in the entire world. So Bhavat Sadhanam Tu Udadihi Asti Katham Shastra Vyastaha. Because of your Shastram or your Bana, you had made that Sthanam for yourself. Bhuhu Iyam Hantakaraha. And this Bhumi, you have ruled this entire bhumi. Hantakara, there is a lot of debate over what that meaning is. Many different commentators say different meaning. So here you can say you have made this entire bhumi as your atithi. Hantakaraha is another meaning of that is atithi, because he is those who rule the earth are kings, and he had won over all the kings, or he had just destroyed all the kings. He's the avatara purusha. The purpose of his avatara was to destroy the kshatriyas, and since he had destroyed all the kshatriyas, the entire bhumi was his to give away in danam. So that is the hantakara. One meaning of that is that, which I find is very nice, because he's the sole owner of this bhumi, and it is his to give away. So bhuriyam yam bhumihi hantakaraha dana yogyaha asti. Now Ravana accepts, gives all these positive points, then he gives the negative point and says, I don't want to fight with you for just one reason. Astyeva etat kimu renuka kantabadam kritavata tava parashuna saha. There is one minus point for your parashu, the axe that you use. Tava parashuna, how is that parashu? He gives an adjective for that. Renuka kantabadam kritavata. Astyeva etat kimu. There is just one, in Tamil we say naradal. It is a small problem area that I have with you. Ravana says, Renuka kantabadam kritavata tava parashuna baddha spardaha mama chandrahasaha lajjate. My sword Chandrahasa, Ravana's sword's name is Chandrahasa. Chandrahasa lajjate, it is ashamed to even compete with your parashuna, with your parashu. Why? Because Renuka kantabadam, this parashu is responsible for killing Renuka, your mother. Kantha, he is supposed to have killed his mother Renuka. Renuka kantabadam kritavata parashuna tava parashuna saha mama chandraha saha baddhaspardaha lajjate. To compete with your parashu, because it has cut your mother's neck, so in order to compete with that, my sword is feeling very ashamed to do that. Very nice shloka. So he talks very highly of Parashurama by saying, Chapacharyaha Tripura Vijayi Kartikeyaha Vijayaha Shastravyastaha Sadhana Mudadihi Bhuriyam Hantakaraha Astyeva Yetat Kimu. Why? See, what can I say? There is just one problem where your Parashu was used to kill your mother. That is where I feel ashamed. That is not a Veera Lakshana. Huh? Now let's look at the dosha. Atra Vijayaha iti kritya pratyayaha ktapratyayarthe avachakaha. Now ktapratyaya is used for indicating something which has happened in the past. So if I say vijitaha kartikeyaha vijitaha, and ji dhatu, behind the ji dhatu, if I put the ktapratyaya, you get the form of jitaha vijitaha. So there I can say kartikeyaha vijitaha, which means Skanda has been defeated by you, or you have defeated Skanda. Whereas Vijayaha is Jetum Yogyaha. The Yat Pratyaya, the Kriti Pratyaya that you use here for Ji Dhatu is actually Vijayaha, where the meaning comes out as Jetum Yogyaha or Jetum Shakyaha. Both can be, depends, Vijayaha and Jayaha. There is a difference. I always get confused with that. One is Jetum Shakyaha, one is Jetum Yogyaha. So neither can be used here, because the meaning that the poet wishes to convey is Kartikeyaha Twaya Jitaha Ityeva Arthaha Atra Vivakshitaha. Parantu Vijayaha, that Kritya Pratyayam cannot convey the meaning of Kta Pratyayam. See, sometimes we can use Jitavan for Jitaha. Jitavan, he defeated. Ktavato can maybe express ktaprateya in cases. Whereas the kritya pratyayam of yat cannot express ktaprateyartha. Ktapratyayasya tu atitartha yat pratyayasya krityam, that which has to be done, which is in the future. or which has to be done later. So yat pratyaya's meaning itself is very different, whereas kata pratyaya, the tense or the time itself is does not match. Hence, vivakshita artha is not given. So the what being the poet wishes to convey through this is not reaching the audience. Hence, the reader cannot understand what he is trying to get. So the problem, immediately the rasa badakam will happen. So everything ultimately should lead to why the rasa is not being able to appreciate it by the audience. Okay. So atra vijayaha iti kritya pratyaha tapratyayarthe avachakaha. Now the next one is ashlilam. Let's look at what we saw before. For ashlilam, there are three types of ashlila: vrida, amangalam, and jugupsa. So vrida dayakam, where you're very ashamed to even read that shloka, and it gives a very or the next one is jugupsa, you are disgusted by the meaning that it gives. Amangalam is which is an inauspicious thing which should not be mentioned in a kavyam. So we saw the padakatam and vakyakatam also in various places. Now here, padaika amsham is what we are seeing. So padaika deshagata is only a pratyayam, or just two letters of one word can even convey that. Okay. So the first one is vridadayakam, atipelamam, atiparimitam. अतिपेलवम् अतिपरिमितवर्णम् लघुतरम् उदाहरति शठः परमार्थतः स हृदयम् वहति पुनः कालकूटघटितमिव. इस् टाकिङ्ग् आफ् शठः खलः दुष्टपुरुषः दुर्जनः. हौ हि टाक्स् द वे हि स्पीक्स् इस् अतिपेलवम्. हि स्पीक्स् वित् अ वेरी soft words, he uses soft words, atyanta komala varnaha varna yutaha tasya vakyam. So ati pelavam ati parimita varnam laghutaram udaharati shataha. Durjanaha, a bad person might say very soft ati parimita varnam. Parimitam is measured words. In Raghuvamsham, when Kalidasa is describing the Raghuvamsha kings, he will start off with ajanma shuddhanam aphalodaya karmanam. In that he will say satyaya mitabhashinam. See, people, the Raghuvamsha kings, Raghunam anvayam vakshe, while giving all the visheshanas or the gunas of the Raghuvamsha kings, he says satyaya mitabhashinam. They speak very measured, in a very measured manner, not because they don't have the vocabulary, not because they don't know how to express themselves. Satyaya, in order to convey only the truth, because satyam bruyat priyam bruyat na bruyat satyam apriyam, even if it is apriyam satyam, you should not speak it out. So that is the rules of speech. You have to talk in a measured manner so that you convey only the truth, so that you speak only the truth, and you try to speak less and less. I'm sure that will never work for lecturers, because their goal is to speak more. Satyaya mitabhashinam ati parimita varnam. Whereas here, in contrast, he says a Durjana uses parimita varnam, because he is gauging how the other person is. He tries to see and measure his words in such a manner that, you know, how can I speak in such a manner that this fellow will get convinced by whatever I say. So he's inside his mind, the heart is filled with kalakuta ghatitam. Kalakutam is like a visham. So paramarthataha, in reality, shatasya hridayam tu kalakuta ghatitam iva vahati saha hridayam. His mind is filled with poison. Because of that, he chooses his words carefully so that the other person will fall into his trap. How does he use the word? He uses atipelavam, very soft words, atiparimita varnam, very measured letters, and laghutaram. He speaks in a very soft manner. So not all Durjana are very loud spoken, and very, when you are loud and when you speak in a very not harsh, not every harsh person is a bad person. there can be nothing in their mind, and so they speak the truth in a straightforward manner also. So here he talks of a shataha, a person who uses crooked way to speak. So ati pelavam ati parimita varnam lagudaram udaharati shataha paramarthataha. In reality, how is his heart? Saha hi vahati hridayam vahati. He bears a heart which is punaha kalakuta ghatitam iva punaha. It is as if it is mixed. It is ghatitam means it is made of kalakuta. It is made with poison. So it's a very nice shloka. I don't feel like even saying the dosha in this. So the pelava shabdaha, in the shabdam pelavam, the just the amsha, pela is the amsha which is the problem factor. It indicates the guhya part, guhyanga. Pela is also another meaning for it, is guhyangam, which is the private part. And we should try to avoid such combinations of words. You can use ati komalam ati parimita varnam lagutaram udaharati shakaha. The same meaning will be conveyed even with that. It's better not to use such words. Next shloka is he's pointing out the dosham of ashleelam, jugupsa variety, which is jugupsa dayakam. It generates a disgust in our mind. Yav puyate sura sarit mukha teertha sartha snanena shastra parishilana keelanena saujanya manya janihi urjitam urjitanam soyam drishoho patati kasyachi deva pumsaha. One who is a very scholar or an intelligent person will fall in the eyes of only a sukriti, one who has done a lot of punya. Kasyachit eva pumsaha drushoho. Kasyachit means only sukritina. Sukritinaha purushasya eva lochanayoho patati. Lochana vishayaha bhavati. Yaha, the one who is purifies the entire world. Puyate pavitri karoti. Yaha jagat pavitri karoti. Katham sura sarit mukha tirtha sartha snanena. Or one who is purified by bathing in the Ganga. Always one, you know, a scholar who constantly bathes in the, who is purified because of bathing in the Ganges, Sura Sarit Devanadi, Ganga, Tasya Mukha Tirtha. So Mukham means the entrance point or ghat, you say, right? So that is the Sura Sarit Mukham. Tadeva Tirtham. So it is like Prayag or all those places are called Tirthasthalam. And Sartha Snanena. Sartha means one who takes bath in the Tirtha Samuham. See, Devanadi flows, see, Ganga flows, and there are a lot of Tirthasthala in its Mukham. Mukham is its delta, where it goes and joins the Samudram, that is called the Mukham. And either in the delta portion, or if you look at Prayag and Varanasi, there are many ghats that are there. That is called the Tirtha Sartha, which is the Tirtha Samuha. So Tirtha Sthala Samuhe Yaha Snanam Kritva Puyate Pavitri Karoti. Shariram Yaha Sva Shariram Evam Pavitri Karoti Ganga Snanena. So sura saritu mukha tirtha sartha snanena yaha pavitri karoti. What is the other way that he does? Shastra parishilana keelanena. Shastra parishilana abhyasena. Keelanena samskara dridikaranam. That is your keelanam. Keelanam means, it is actually, you know, the wedge that you put inside a wood. When you are cutting a wood, and you want to put a wedge inside it, it goes and fixes itself in that point. That is called the keelanam. Keelakam is that wedge. Keelanam is dridhi karanam. You are trying to fix something. By what? Shastra parashilanena keelanam. You are establishing ideas by analyzing the shastra. स्वशास्त्रपरिशीलनेन यत् कीलनं भवति तेन पवित्रीक्रियते यः जनः. सो अ स्कालर् हू इस् आल्सो बीङ्ग् प्यूरिफैड् बिकास् आफ् अनलैसिङ्ग् द शास्त्र. सो हि इस् एन् इण्टेलिजेण्ट् पर्सन्. नाट् ओन्लि इण्टेलेक्चुअलि हि इस् है, हि आल्सो प्राक्टिसिस् by doing Gangasnanam, so he doesn't have any papam. The next is Saujanya Manya Janihi. His kulam is also a great kulam. He belongs to a very impressive ancestry. Saujanya Manya Janihi. His birth is manya. It is honorable because of the, it is very respectable birth because of Saujanya. Because he has that quality. If his birth has that quality of Sujanata, which means it has been given to him right from birth by his parents or by his kulam. So Saujanya Manya Janihi, his birth, which is respectable because of that Sujanata, noble character. And then Urjitam, Urjitanam cha Urjitam yaha. Urjitanam, Urjas is Tejaha. One who is the courageous or the brave among the brave, one who is the most courageous among the brave, such a person, saha ayam janaha kasya chideva pumsaha drishoho patati. Now imagine a person who has all of these qualities. If someone has to look upon such a person, the person who looks at that person should have done great punyam. So kasya chideva pumsaha, only one among thousands or millions of person can come across a person who is intellectual, who is also practicing and who is pure, who also has a very congenial quality, who is also noble and who is brave. So all these qualities combined in one person, if we have to see that, then we should have done so much of punyam in our purva janma. Now let's go to Mammata. What is he say? Atra Puya Shabdaha. Puyate, Puya itself, Pu is the Dhatu, Punati, Puyate is Pavitri Kriyate, Pung Pavane is the Dhatu, and in Karmani Prayoga, Latlakara, it is Puyate. There, just the Amsha of Puya, it means, you know, the pus green color thing that comes from the wound. You have a wound and it is infected, the green liquid that comes out of that, that is called Puyaha. So it reminds us of that. So unless the dictionary tells me or the Vyakhyata tells me, we would never know that such a word existed. Because we don't study Ayurvedam or anything, right? So we are only Kavya readers. Maybe a person who comes from Ayurveda background would immediately say, oh, why is he using this word Puya? That will immediately give rise to Jugupsa. Now that I have said, now that I also know that Puya means pus, the moment we read a Kavyam, that word will be stuck in our mind and it will create that Jugupsa or disgust in our mind immediately. So a Kavi should avoid these words. You have Puyate. Surasarin mukhasa tirtha sartha snanena shastra parishilana kilanena saujanya manya janihi urjitam urjitanam soyam drishov patati kasyajideva pumsaha. The next one is amangalartham. Vinaya pranayaika ketanam satatam yo abhavat anga tadrishaha kathamadya satad vikshyatam tadvat vikshyatam tadabhipreta padam samagataha. Hey anga, yaha vinaya pranayaika ketanam satatam abhavat tadrishaha vinaya pranayaika ketanam abhavat saha adya katham tadvat vikshyatam tadabhiprepta padam samagataha. There can be two contexts to the shloka. We don't know what the context is, but we will try to imagine a context here. Maybe a friend who has changed his attitude. So, you know, these best friends, kids have these best friends, and suddenly one of the best friend would say, you know, you're no longer my friend, and go away. So it is something like that. So this person who was very friendly now has become completely to the other side, or he has associated himself with a bad company. So the one who was his friend is talking about this situation where, you know, how can I even look at that person when he has gone and associated himself with bad company? That is the idea that he is being, it is being portrayed here. The one who was initially, before he was Vinaya Pranaya Eka Ketanam Yaha Abhavat, you know, he was my, the only solace for Vinaya and Pranaya. He showed extreme discipline in his attitude, Vinaya, and Pranayam. Pranayam is friendship. He also showed a great friendship towards me. He was the receptacle, Ketanam. Ketanam is the bhavanam. Yaha vinayasya pranayasya cha yeka bhavanam asit purvam tadrishaha saha. He Anga. Anga is he Mitra. He katam saha adya today. Saha tadvad katham saha vikshyatam. How can I look at him in the same manner today? Yat tad apipretapadam samagataha. Tad apipretapadam. Tasya abhipretam ishtam padam yaha samagataha. Tasya abhipretam padam means he has gone to his ishtam padam. That, you can say, you can take it as bad company. Abhipretam is abhilashitam padam or neecham padam. Abhilashitam means he wants to go and join with that bad company. I can't help it. Now, how do I look at him? Tadvad katham vikshyatam. How can I look at him in the same manner that I looked at him before when he was a Vinaya and Pranaya Eka Ketanam? Yaha Eka Ketanam Asit Pranayasya Vinayasya cha Tadvadeva Adhuna Maya katham vikshyate ayam. Because I am to adhuna abhipreta padam samagataha. Abhipreta padam tu atra neecha padam. We have to take it as in that manner. Contextually, we have to take it. Or another context, being a kavyam, you can always say a nayika is talking about a nayaka who wants to be with another woman, and he has gone to that anya nayika sangataha yaha. So you can say Vinaya Pranaya Eka Ketanam Yaha Abhavat Purvam. Hey Anga, she is talking to her Sakhi and saying, you know, she was the Nayaka was the only solace for me, and he was a representation of Vinaya and Pranaya for me. Now, because he has gone to another girl, another Nayika, Anya Nayika Sangataha, Abhipreta Padam, he wanted to go and be with her. So he has gone and gone to her. So tad Abhipreta Padam Samagataha Saha Katham Adya Tadvat Vikshyatam Tadvat Ityukte Purva Anubhutavat. Just like how I had seen him before, how can I look at him again in the same manner? He is not anymore that disciplined person who is only looking at me today, right? So you can look at it in a non-Shringara manner, where just two friends are talking about another friend, or you can look at it in a through a Shringara manner, where one Nayaka has gone to Anya Nayika Sangataha Ekaha. That also is possible. Whichever manner, now the dosham exists here with the amsha abhipretam, atra preta shabdaha. Here, abhipretam is priyam. Abhilashitam is the meaning of that word, and preetihi pranayaha is the idea that is conveyed from the abhipretam padam. Now that abhipretam, only that preta shabdaha means gata asuhu. One who is dead, mritaha, and it is the corpse, that is the idea that comes up in our mind. Preta means corpse. So this type of amangala suchaka padam, padamsham, you should avoid. So here, this is ashleelam amangalartham. With this, the three varieties of ashleela is over. The next one is sandigdham. Sandigdham, I think we saw... Padagatam was Vandyam. In Padagatam Dosham, we saw Vandyam, where Vandi is the word, where Vandi Krataha, Karagrahe Nikshiptaha, Karagrahe Nikshipta, Esha. So that can be Vandi, Vandijana, a person who is a prisoner of war. And then in the Saptami Vibhakti, it is Vandyam, Nadi Nadyam. That way it can be looked upon as. Or Vandya, Vandana Yogya Ya Mahila. Tasyam, so Vandyam Ashif Paramparam. So the Vandana Yogyam Ashif Paramparam Kuru. That was the shloka that we saw in Padagata Dosham. And Vakyagatam, we saw there were many words that could have indicated either way. So in that Suralaya Ullasa, we saw how it could have gone to a sannyasi and a person who visits the bar, Suralayam. Sura is intoxication. So one who always constantly does Madhirapana. Now this one, here we have to look only at a Padamsha Dosha. So what is the shloka that he says? Kasmin karmani samarthyam asya na uttapateyataram ayam sadhucharaha tasmat anjalihi badhyatam iha atrakim purvam sadhu uta sadhushu charati iti sandeha. Now, 1 minute. This is easier. So padaikadesham sandigdham, the shlokam here is kasmin karmani samarthyam asya na uttapateyataram ayam sadhucharaha tasmat iha anjalihi badhyatam. Sandigdham always means two meanings are going to come out of the shloka and we don't know what the poet insists. What is the poet's vivaksha? Right? What are the two meanings that get... Let's look at a cursory meaning. So which is asya samarthyam. Kasmin karmani na uttapateetaram. Asya samarthyam. Someone is talking about another person, saying, talking about his capabilities. Asya samarthyam, his capability... one who is, you know, he is capable of, so in what work does he does not shine? Uttapate. Uttapate is prakashate. Just like how Suryaha uttapate, Suryaha prakashate. In the same manner, uttapate means eshaha janaha kasmin karmani va na prakashate. Sarve, sarvasmin api karmani. He shines forth in every action, every aspect. Uttapate taram, here tarap pratyaya can be added to the verb also, kriyapadam also, to indicate a comparative. He shines better than everybody. That's what it means. So you can even say uttapate tamam, which will indicate that he shines forth the best among everybody as a comparative and superlative. So here, asya samarthyam, this person's capability, kasmin karmani, in which work does this person, na uttapateetaram, does he not shine forth in a very great manner? Ayam sadhucharaha. So this person is a sadhuchara. That is your problem word. So let me just take it as that. Sadhucharaha, tasmat, hence, iha anjalihi badhyatam. I fold my hands. That's all he says. He doesn't say whether it is, you know, I don't want to see him at all. You can fold your hands and say into meaning. Right? One, you can say, I respect you, so I fold anjali baddhaha eshaha bahumanena. It can be because of respect. Otherwise, it can be say, you know, Niku namaskara, vidikku namaskara. I want to bow my hands and say, you know, I don't even want to lie in your direction at all. I don't want to have any association with you. So let me do the final namaskara for you. That can also be an anjali bandha. It can also mean antima namaskara, where I don't want your association. Now, what is the, why does both meaning can come about where there is a sandeha in the sense, sadhucharaha being the problem word, the chara can occur in two ways. There are two Panini sutras which are applicable here. One is, it can be a charat pratyaya or it can be a charadato with a ta pratyaya. Two things can occur. Let's look at the first meaning where bahumanena anjali bandhaha. So how does that go? Sadhushu yaha charati saha sadhucharaha. One who roams around with sadhu, one who is always in a good company. So he is capable of doing everything, all work. He shines forth in every action that he does because he is also in the company of sadhus. Sadhushu yaha charati. Sadhu charaha. Ataha bahumanena ayam anjali. Iyam anjalihi badhyadam. So let me, you know, bow to you. I bow to you in respect. This comes from Chareshtaha, which is a Panini Sutra in Ashtadhyayi, where Charadhatoho Tapratyayaha Subanta Upapade Sati. Subanta Upapadam is Sadhu, is the Upapada here. Just like how Kumbhakaraha, Kumbham Karoti iti Kumbhakaraha, which is an Upapada Samasa. In the same way here also, Sadhushu Yaha Charati, Sadhu Charaha. Charadhatoho Tapratyayaha Bhavati Atra. The other way you can look at this is, Bhutapurvaha sadhu, who was a sadhu before, now I don't know what work he does. Asya samartyam kasmin karmani va na uttapate etara. He is very good even in good work. The same goes for bad actions also. He is extreme. He shines forth in all types of actions, both good actions and bad actions. Bhutapurvaha sadhu ayam. So there, Bhutapurve Charata is a pratyaya that is added. So whether the amsha of chara is a charadhatoho tapratyaya, athava charata pratyaya atra upayujyate iti sandehaha vartate. So Bhutapurve Charata, Bhutapurvatva vishishte arthe, vartamanate, pratipadikate, sadhu iti pratipadikate, Charat pratyayaha atra upayujyate. Now, what does that mean? Bhutapurvaha sadhu. Adhya charaha is the example that Kashika, in Kashika, he gives the example of adhya charaha. Adhyaha means dhanikaha, one who was wealthy. Wealthy person is an adhyaha, aishwarya yuktaha, adhyaha purushaha. Purvam yaha adhyaha, adhuna adhyaha nasti, adhuna daridraha asti, ityarthe adhya charaha, iti charat pratyaha upayujyate. So if I say adhya charaha, it means yaha purvam dhanavan asit, adhuna na, hi adhuna daridraha. So bhuta purvaha, purvam bhutaha, bhuta purvaha, yaha sadhu. So here sadhu charaha means he was a very great person before. He was a sadhu before. Adhunatu durjanaha asti. Iti karanat sadhu charaha. He was a sadhu. He is no longer a sadhu. Tasmat. Hence, iha anjalihi badyatam. Asya sangayeva na ichhami. I don't want his association at all. So two meanings can arise from this, that just that chara is the pada amsha where there is a dosham because it is sandigdham. The meaning is confusing. We don't know where the meaning lies. Yes, you have a doubt?
Yeah, Bhagini, I was thinking, so this may be an independent shloka, but it will have a context in the story. So from that, it would be understood. So should we look at doshas like on individual shloka basis?
Absolutely. So the thing is, if this had occurred in a context, then it would have been very easy to fix the meaning. Whether it is sadhu charaha, bhutapurvaha sadhu, athava sadhushu charati iti sandarbha, it is very easy to fix that sandarbha when we have the entire kavya on hand. Suppose this was just we are looking at, see, doshas are always given only just to know what the dosha can be. That's all it means. So if your context is there, then there is no dosha at all. Sandigdham arises only when we suddenly come across a shloka. Someone just, you know, you are browsing the internet, you suddenly come up with a shloka. And you just see that shloka. There is no context. Nobody has given that context. Then what do you take the meaning as? Then there is a sandigdham there, correct?
Got it. Thank you.
Yeah. Otherwise, when there is a context, there is no dosha. It is very clear. So even for pronouns, for example, if we say saha evam karoti, who is that saha? You always have to fix that context for that saha. Yaha and saha, there should be that context there. If the context is absent, then at least the shloka should give some clue to that context. There is no clue to that context in the shloka. If it had occurred in a kavyam, then there is no issue there. If we are talking about, say, Durjana Paddhati, then fine. The shloka would fit perfectly and we will say it is a Bhutapurvaha Sadhu. If it was a Sajjana Paddhati, like in Niti Shatakam, you have Sajjana Paddhati and he is talking about a Sadhu, then the context is fixed here. Since we don't know the context on hand, that is why the Sandigdha Dosha occurs.
Thank you.
So, atra kim purvam sadhu uta sadhushu charati iti sandehaha. Now, the last one is neyartham. Again, neyartha kim uchyate asya bhupala maulihi. Let's look at what we did. Neyartha is lakshana. So, lakshana is where your mukhyartha vada happens. Mukhyartha vade tad yoge. Ruditaha ata prayojanat. Your mukhyartha does not fit, vachyartha does not fit. Because the vachyartha does not fit, you go for the sambandham, and then with the sambandha, you go for a lakshyartha, intended meaning. When the primary meaning does not fit, you go for the intended meaning, and that intended meaning can be either by popular convention or it has a reasoning for which I am using this word. Gangayam Goshaha is the example we give, just to give a small recap for what this Neyartha is. Gangayam Goshaha, when I say there is a hamlet on Ganges, Gangayam Utajaha Vidyate, Ganga per se cannot have an Utaja because the Ganga primary meaning is Pravaha, the flow of Ganges. So that Mukhyartha Badhyate, Mukhyartha Badhyate, so you go to an associated meaning where Ganga Tire, the Tira is associated with Ganga. So you say Ganga Tire Ghoshaha Vidyate, Bhavitum Shaknoti. Hence, why do we do that? Prayojana. Gangayam Yadrisham Sheetalatvam Vartate Pavanatvam Vartate Tadrisham Eva Pavanatvam Sheetalatvam Cha Ghoshe Vartate Iti Karanat Atra Lakshana Upayujyate. We use Ganga instead of Ganga Tira to indicate that Sheetalatvam and Pavanatvam for the Gosha. That is why we use. That is Prayojana. Rudhi means where by popular convention, Pankaja is lotus. Pankajam is lotus. Pankata Jayate. Anything that comes from mud is not only lotus. It can be lily. It can even be a worm. But Pankajam only indicates lotus because by popular convention, we have only taken it as lotus. People have only used it in the meaning of lotus. Nobody has used it in the meaning of worm. Right? That is Rudhi. So, Rudhitaha Athava Prayojanat Mukhyartham Badhyate, Mukhyartha Badhyate, and then we go to Lakshana, and then Lakshyarthaha is the indicated meaning. That is your Lakshana. Now, what is Neyartham in this? Neyam means where such Rudhi is also absent, Prayojana is also absent, and simply the poet has used one word and he wants you to understand an intended meaning there. Chapeta Patanam we saw, and Vastra Vaidurium also we saw this. You can go back to Padagatam and Vakyagatam for a recap of why that is. Now the present shloka is Kim uchyate asya bhupala mauli mala mahamanehe sudurlabam bachobanehi tejo yasya vibhavyate. This is the shloka that he gives for padaika desha katam. Let's look at the meaning of this. Yasya tejaha vachobanehi, a king whose tejas, whose prakasha, whose bravery sudurlabam vibhavyate. It is very difficult to be understood even by Vachovanaihi Deva, the Devas. Girvanaha are Devaha. So even the gods cannot understand the Tejas, the quality that this king possesses. So Yasya Tejaha, Yasya Ragnyaha Tejaha, Devairapi with a great effort, yatnenaiva vibhavyate, tadrishasya rajnyaha vishaye kimuchyate. What can I say of such a king? Because that king is like the chudamani of all the kings in the world. So Bhupala Mauli Mala, if you think of all the kings who are bowing at the feet of this great king, yasya tejaha devairapi sudurlabham vibhavyate, tasya rajnyaha charane sarve bhupalaha santi. So Bhupala Mauli nam eka mala vidyate, tadrisha malayaha madhyamanihi iva ayam raja vibhavyate. So this king shines, prakashate, he shines like the madhyamani or the chudamani of all the kings in the world. Tadrishasya asya rajnyaha kim uchyate. What can I say of such a great king whose tejas is very difficult to be understood even by the devas? Shloka is beautiful. Now vacho banaihi is the word, problem word. Here vachaha, vachas shabdaha is a paryayavachi for gish shabdaha. Gihi also means vak, speech. Vachaha also means vak. Whereas Girvana is, by popular convention, Girvanaha means Devaha. Or Girvanaha Devaha. You know, the Muppattu Mukkodi Devargal. So all the 33 million, crores of Devas. So that all the Devas together, that Samoham is called Girvanaha. Now what he uses here is Vabayor Abedaha, and he says Bana. Vachaha also, the word itself has been formed from its vyutpatti, from its etymology. The etymological derivation for Girvana is Giraha eva banaha, for those people for whom the speech is like a sharp arrow. So Giraha eva banaha, for those who the speech itself is like an arrow, that is, it hits its target, they can easily give shapam, or they speak very well. There are many things associated with that. It is only an etymological derivation, but that does not fit every deva that is there. Okay, or every speech of ours is like a target, and for that target, asmakam giram gi, or you can say, forget that, because I was thinking of how they can be the target of our words, where we always praise the devas. I was looking at that as a vyutpati. Anyway, the vyutpati here is giraha eva banaha yeshamte girvanaha. You can use that vyutpati. But by popular convention, girvanaha means devaha. Just like pankajam, pankate jayate iti, pankajam kintu kamalameva suchyate. Nadu idu kitadi. In the same way, girvana only describes deva. The same way, only Girvana can describe Deva. Girvana iti shabda combination. Only that combination can indicate Deva. Any other combination cannot indicate Deva. Here, atra vachas shabdena gish shabdaha lakshyate. There is no popular convention to use vachaha instead of gihi. There is no prayojanam to use vachaha instead of gihi. Just like Gangayam Goshaha or like Pankaja. Have that in your mind whenever you're looking at Neyartha Dosha. Atra khalu, in this example, na kevalam purva padam yavate, uttara padam api paryaya parivartanam na kshamate. It is not only the purva padam that you cannot change. You cannot change the purva padam. In the word Girvana, atra ityukte Girvana iti shabde, na kevalam purvapadam, purvapadam ityukte gihi iti padam, parivartanam, paryaya parivartanam na kshamate. Paryayena, I cannot say vakyavanaha, I cannot use vachovanaha, vakvanaha, I cannot use that. The same way, uttarapadam api paryaya parivartanam na kshamate. Uttarapadam, in the sense, gish sharaha, I cannot use that shara word instead of vana. स्वगीश्वराः इत्यपि देवपर्यायः न भवितुम् अर्हति. सो नेक्स्ट् हि गिव्स् अदर् वर्ड्स् आल्सो एस् एक्साम्पल्. इस् दिस् दि ओन्ली वर्ड् दट् केन् बि यूस्ड् फार् नेयार्थ एस् एन् एक्साम्पल् फार् नेयार्थं? देर् आर् अदर् वर्ड्स् दट् केन् आल्सो बि यूस्ड्. सो ममटस् इस् जलधि जलध्यादौ उत्तरपदमेव वडवानलादौ पूर्वपदमेव. इन् गीर्वाण शब्द बोत् गीश् शब्द आल्सो केनाट् बि रीप्लेस्ड्, वाण शब्द केनाट् बि रीप्लेस्ड् आल्सो केनाट् बि रीप्लेस्ड्. सो उत्तरपदं पूर्वपदम् इत्युभयमपि अत्र पर्यायपरिवर्तनं न क्षम्यते. वेरस् जलधियादौ पदे तु उत्तरपदम् एव परिवर्तनं न क्षमते. उत्तरपदम् इत्युक्ते धि. सो जलं जलस्य आधारः इत्यर्थे जलधिः इति शब्दः उपयुज्यते. सो द धि पोर्शन् केनाट् बि चेञ्ज्ड् एट् आल्. यू केन् चेञ्ज् द फस्ट् पोर्शन् वेर् यू केन् से वारिधिः आर् पयोधिः पयसां धीः. इट्स् द रिसेप्टिकल् आर् द पात्रं. वेर् द सेम् वे if you try to change that dhihi into patram, it will not work. So jaladihi indicates samudra, varidihi can also indicate samudra, payodhi also samudram, whereas jala patram cannot indicate samudram. Jalashayaha can probably indicate samudram. Oh, okay, ashayaha is actually adharaha, whereas okay, I don't know how that will work now. Jalashayaha exists. So jalashayaha can indicate tatagaha, koopaha, samudraha also. Nadi, anything can be a jalashaya. Whereas if you want to indicate only samudram, you have to use jaladhihi. Jaladhihi cannot indicate tataka. Okay, I unnecessarily started another doubt, so it's okay now as long as you understood it. So jaladihi can indicate only samudram, jalapatram cannot indicate samudram. You can change the first word, which is purvapadam paryaya parivartanam kshamate, kintu uttarapadam paryaya parivartanam na kshamate. So jaladhyadau tu uttarapadam eva. The same way vadavanaladau purvapadam eva. Vadavanala is an imaginary agni which is supposed to be inside the samudram, which keeps the samudram in check. It is called vadavagni or vadavanala. The vadava is actually ashva. It is a horse. It has got the face of a horse. That is what is there in Purana and popular convention or Puranic encyclopedia. If you look it up, you will know. Vadava is the name of a horse, and the Agni is supposed to have the face of a horse. So, but I can't substitute that Vadava with Ashva and say Ashvanalaha indicates the fire that is there inside the ocean. We cannot say that. But Agni portion can be changed. You can say Vadavanalaha, Vadavagnihi, or anything. Badavagnihi is also fine. But you can't use Ashvanala. Hayanalaha, Hayagnihi, even that is not allowed. So, Purvapadasya, Purvapadameva Paryaya Parivartanam na Kshamate. Kintu Uttarapadam Paryaya Parivartanam Kshamate. Okay, so jaladhyadav and adipadena, you can also say jaladharaha for megha, where you can use varidharaha, payodharaha, but you can't use jalapatram again. You can't say jalashayaha to indicate meghaha. That again is not possible. I'm not sure if there is another example for purvapadameva parivartanam nakshamate. Maybe if we think, we can find out examples for that. So this is your neyartham. With this, our padamsha doshas are over, and we have to go to vakyamatra dosham. Before that, he just gives one small explanation to why there are so many different doshas which are very similar in meaning. The result is only one thing. So yadyapi, that in the text, if you look at it, after वडवानलादौ पूर्वपदमेव देन् हि गिव्स् दिस् यद्यपि असमर्थस्यैव अप्रयुक्तादयः केचन वेदाः तथापि अन्यैः आलङ्कारिकैः विभागेन प्रदर्शिताः इति भेदप्रदर्शनेन उदाहर्तव्याः इति च विभज्य उक्ताः. नौ देर् आर् सो मेनि दोषस् दट् यु हव् मेन्शन्ड् एण्ड् देर् आर् मेनि दोषस् द रिसल्ट् आफ् विच् इस् ओन्लि विवक्षित असमर्थत्वम्. Asamarthatvam is your basis with which all of these doshas have come about. So yadyapi, even though asamarthasyaiva, asamarthatvam is one type of dosha, but asamarthatvam also means vivakshita artha pratiti viraha. Whatever the poet wishes to convey, that artha pratiti is absent. That is your basis for many doshas. Like aprayuktam, nihatartha, viruddham atikrita, neyartha, avachaka, all of these have the basis as vivakshitartha pratitihi na vidyate, tasmat ayam doshaha. Then why do you need so many vedas? Aprayuktaha kechana vedaha, they are only classifications of asamarthatvam, tathapi, even though anyaihi alankarikaihi vibhagena pradarshitaha, but many purva acharyaihi, purva alankarikaha, साहित्यशास्त्रकाराः दे हेव् गिवन् दिस् क्लासिफिकेशन् एण्ड् शोन् दिस् एस् डिफ्रेण्ट् दोषस्. भेदप्रदर्शनेन उदाहर्तव्याः इत्येव विभज्य उक्ताः. जस्ट् टु शो दट् स्लैट् डिफ्रेन्स् बिट्वीन् द अप्रयुक्तं निहतार्थं नेयार्थम् इफ् यु लुक् एट् अप्रयुक्तं दैवतः इस् दि एक्साम्पल् दट् हि सेस् फार् पदगतं. दैवतम् इस् द popular usage that is there in Kavisamaya, whereas Daivataha as a pullinga word has never been used, but Kosha in Amarakosham etc. it says Kvachit Pumsi. It can be used in pullinga, but it has never been used in pullinga. So suddenly if someone uses Daivataha, then the Vivakshitartha is not there. So it is only further, it is a classification of Asamartha, but it need not be treated as a separate dosha. But in order to show the different Veda along with its Udaharanam, Veda Pradarshanena Udahartavyaha, Kimartham Anyehi Alankarikaihi Vibhagena Pradarshitaha iti Karanath, Atra Maya Api Veda Pradarshanena Udaharanani Dattani. So iti Vibhajya Uktaha. Yes. Inna Kilvi. Now I can't see this question pane, ma. Can you read it out? Connects because that propriety is absent. The very fact that there is a dosha is because that propriety is absent. Yeah. So it need not be only for asamarthatva. Apo mattadala eppadi agum shruti katu alla enna ardu. Shruti katu is not asamarthatva. Shruti katu is not vivakshitartha pratyaya viraha. You can take it in a very superset way and say that it is vivakshitartha pratyaya viraha. Adha vandu don't look at anauchityam as a different concept as such. Auchityam as a separate concept, you can say asamarthatvam is anauchityam, but I prefer not to use that. Anauchityam is a more auchityam is a more beautiful concept than this, and it is a thread for all the doshas. Here, this asamarthatvam specifically goes only to say how one word or one vakyam does not give the meaning that the poet wishes to convey. Okay, so with this, the padamsha doshaha are over, and he has given us only 7 of those doshas. Then next we have to go for Vakya Matra Dosha. We will do that next class. If there is any doubt, you can send me a question and we will address it during the next class. Namaste.